new gear. So let's jump into this gear update for bushcrafting. And essentially, last year was the first year of water-based bushcrafting endeavors, and this year is going to continue that. And we're also going to be trying to incorporate more horseback adventures as well. So starting off with the firearms, we're going to take a look at these. The first is the Winchester 94. Now this isn't going to be primarily what I'm carrying when I'm on foot or just hiking or sloshing through the water, but through horseback, this is definitely going to be the go-to firearm of choice. And these two firearms are primarily set up for more defense, and that's because we're going to be, like I said, in the backwoods hiking, hunting, camping, and it's nice to have some defensive options. So the first is the Winchester 94, and then of course, as you guys saw last year, the Glock 21. This is my go-to for going out in the backwoods when I don't want something big, heavy, long like this 94 weighing me down. A really lightweight, reasonably compact handgun like this 21 makes a really great choice for protection and self-defense. So those are my two firearms that you guys will primarily be seeing for the bushcraft out. So next onto the stuff that's going to be on my body during this time is going to be the Maxpedition Janus pocket extension, and this is my personal survival kit, or PSK. I've gone over this in many different videos, why it's important to have and all that fun stuff, but this is the PSK. Next to that is going to be the primary bushcrafting knife, of course, with its expansion on it that's geared toward fishing and being on the river's edge. So that is the primary bushcrafting knife. Sorry, this is the CRK Pacific, for those who are unfamiliar with this blade. And of course, I modified it a little bit to reduce the top kind of like hump on it. So that is the primary knife and its kind of rig. And then lastly is a Maxpedition roly-poly. And this is the large, or the jumbo, whatever they call it, roly-poly. And all this thing is, for those who don't know, is a dump pouch that just rolls up or folds up. The piece is a little bit big to fit on my small little black table, but this is a Alps Mountaineering, a Lynx 4, and I wanted to get a four-person tent because I wanted something that could hold me, my wife, and a friend, because some of the operations we're planning on doing this summer are, it's going to be us three, so I wanted to have a system that could hold three people. Now, some people may ask, why'd you get a four-person tent for three people, but as those who are familiar with tents, you do generally have to buy at least one person larger than what you're really expecting, because these tents are meant to hold four people, like at maximum cramped, and it's not very comfortable. So if you want to hold three to two people comfortably, you're going to want to have a four-person tent. So that's why I went with the Lynx 4. I like the Lynx 4 because even though this is a four-person tent, you guys can see here it still is relatively compact and it's reasonably light. I believe this weighed in at about 7 pounds. So that is a little bit heavy, but if you consider the fact that this is with stakes, with rain fly, with tent, so this is everything for, you know, most conditions, three seasons, then it's not a horribly heavy, and you'll kind of see why or how I've balanced this out. The next piece that does not fit very well on this black table is a two-person sleeping bag. This one's just basically a generic one off of Amazon, but to be completely honest, the two-person sleeping bags by really common or well-known brands are stupid expensive, like well over $400 to $500, sometimes $600 or $700. And this one, significantly cheaper, under $100, and it's actually served my wife and I very well. Granted, once again, you know, we're not really going out in the negative temperatures to do a lot of camping with tents, so it's not like we're going out into brutal cold and we need a really good, you know, seriously cold rated tent, or sorry, sleeping bag. But this one does the trick for us very well. We stay warm, we stay protected, and we've already used the heck out of this thing last summer when we went on different camping trips, and just in the hammock, this worked pretty well. So that going over to the backpack, and this is one spot, and I like to kind of say this, and I like to kind of mention this because it may materialize or it may not, but it's in the works, and that is that. This is my Camelback linchpin, but I am definitely going to be replacing this in the near future just because this backpack system, while as great as it is showing signs of wear. There's lots of cuts, rips, and damage to it, which is not bad. It's to be expected. This pack has seen a lot of miles over the last 6 years. I've had it for 6 years and used the heck out of this thing. So it has been through a lot, and it's definitely ready for retirement because I have just used the heck out of it. However, going into this year, still the Camelback linchpin, but will likely be replaced by a Mystery Ranch crew cab just because I like the expandability and versatility of the crew cab. Now, for this year, I have completely changed the loadout and way that this is set up. Up here in this little pouch, I have the GPS up here, so the Garmin Organ 650, and I have a Platypus Gravity Works 2 liter, and that is all I have in there. So next, moving over to this little side pouch here, I have not a whole lot in this one, but I have the just a plastic bag, as you guys can see there, and this is where I'm carrying my fire kit for starting fires and doing firecraft. Moving to this primary pouch here is where I have the majority of my stuff. So this is basically all the cooking, water, all that kind of stuff falls into here. So I have the titanium bot in here, as well as with the titanium bot hanger. I have drink mixes, teas, trail mix, cliff bars, all that kind of fun stuff just sits conveniently right in here. And like I said, that's the majority of what I'm actually carrying for bushcraft is all in there. And then I have a little bit of paracord in this kind of clamshell area. And then I have some different kind of bits and bobs over here, just like some extra paracord, the fire fire stove, fire box, and then I have the ferro rod for the backpack all in here. And on the flip side, way over here, where you can see my hand, is on that side, that pouch just has the extensive IFAC in it. I'm not gonna dig into it because I've already dug into that in other videos. So in here, into the big pouch, you guys can see it's very empty, and that's because I honestly was trying to cut as much weight and space so that I could accommodate the 4-person tent and the 2-person sleeping bag, which take up a majority of the room being strapped to the backpack. So what I have here is a tarp / mylar coated on the inside. It's mylar coated tarp essentially right here, and I have this to act as a kind of sun fly for when you're out on the beach. If you guys know, if you're working by a river and you're like actually on the beach of the river, there's absolutely nothing to protect you from the sun, and the sun's hitting you from the water and from the sky. So I like to carry a little fly that I can just set up with like a twig or a branch that I find or some driftwood. It's really easy to set up a fly. So essentially, using this as a rain fly, and that's primarily why, or not rain fly, well, rain fly and a sun fly, so just something quick. Then I just have the Silky Big Boy in here, just for firewood processing, for driftwood processing, just doing whatever I need to do. And that makes this entire area very empty, and once again, it makes the pack very lightweight. But then you add the 4-person tent and the 2-person sleeping bag, and it's right back at its normal weight. So anyways, that's really all that I have to show for this setup. Once again, we'll likely be replacing this pack here with a crew cab just because this poor Camelback linchpin has been beat to hell and it really needs to be replaced. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and hopefully you've enjoyed this and hopefully you've learned some new stuff. And as always, God bless, and I'm out.